So I should ask you about the film. Do we know anything more about the film other than that a bus blows up in it?
Not really. All we know is that it's Jackie Chan, Pierce Brosnan. It's called The Foreigner. It's obviously an action movie. And in fact, some people saying on social media, isn't it wonderful that people are actually doing their own stunts these days and that this is actually taking place? It hasn't been done with CGI. It's actually happened. And so there's been a real mixed bag of reaction to this, positive and negative.
Thank you very much, Anna O'Neill, journalist for BBC London. Mike Parry, broadcaster, has seen some of the criticism, haven't you, Mike?
Yes, I certainly have. And my initial reaction, and my overwhelming reaction is, this is all about the fear factor. This is all about, you know, what makes us frightened in modern life today. Now, I know this is a terrible cliche to say the terrorists have won, but if we stop doing these sort of stunts on the streets of London, one of the world's iconic cities, then the terrorists have won. And the fear factor thing is all about, shaking and trembling when we hear something like this. I wish this happened every weekend in London. I wish every weekend in London somebody was jumping off the top of the tallest building in London. It used to be the NatWest Tower, it's now the Shard or whatever. I wish speedboats were roaring up and down the River Thames.
Well, that's different, though. That's not about a terrorist attack.
Well, it could be, couldn't it? If people saw boats rushing up down the Thames with men in black gear and holding machine guns that could easily be a terrorist attack. And what I want to say is that the minute we say we've got to actually control our city, London, and the feelings of people in London to suit the current mood about terrorism, we've lost. We've lost the battle. This should happen all the time. There's nothing wrong with it happening. I mean, I have read about, you know, kids being frightened and all that. Actually, children love explosions. Now, I'm not being trite when I say that, but, you know, they don't get frightened about explosions. It's all very exciting. What's going on? Is it happening here? I think it's wonderful. When you see the way somebody like New York, you know, uses their city as a film set. Years ago, when I lived in New York in the 80s, I came out of my apartment, I walked round the corner, and there was this massive great yacht parked on Third Avenue. Huge damn thing. And you know what they were doing? It was the end of Romancing the Stone. You know when Michael Douglas eventually finds the diamond, he buys the boat and he takes it down to her apartment? It was a magnificent sight. And the cops had just closed off 10 blocks around. That's what they do in New York.
We have been very bad. Go on, Anna, you're going to say something.
London is used as a film set.
Not enough.
All the time.
But 20 years ago, people would park up to film and they'd all get wheel clamped.
Yeah.
So exactly. that may have changed. I don't know.
They do get filming permission. It happens very regularly, quite often in the early hours of the morning. Yeah. We don't notice it. It's not always as dramatic as this. And it brings a lot of money into for councils.
But your worry, Mike, is that people start saying you can't have explosions. Then you can't have anything. Is that right?
Well, it's not just that. It's just the fact that an explosion should cause... I mean, I'm looking at a national newspaper here. It's done on page one. It's done on page four and five. And the headline is moronic. Mm. I'm sorry. It's not moronic. It's not moronic to use one of the world's great cities as a backdrop to a great film. And by the way, sorry, just to fill in on what the film's all about, you know that Pierce Brosnan stars Gerry Adams in this film, and part of it is about an IRA plot and an explosion. Well, I'm sorry to have to say, but those sort of things did happen historically. It's very accurate to do that, and I don't think you could do it any other way.
Thank you very much indeed, Mike Parry, broadcaster, and Anna O'Neill with BBC London.